When the consumerist lifestyle collapses as it always must, a lone traveler stumbles onto the road to experience a life on its peripheries, next to the edge itself, the Oregon coast, where Lewis and Clark and the Corps of Discovery planted their flag in the sand and turned around to go home. The flag marks the place where the story begins, or perhaps not. Henry David Thoreau discovered the trailhead but left the trail itself unmapped. A walk in this forest will not be the same in 100 years, the experience marred by the effects of over-harvesting and erosion, global environmental change, and locally and regionally invasive species. The stillness that soothed Thoreau is still magic balm for the modern mind, but remains as relatively unused as the freedom it inspired. In an age of non-stop image bombardments and routine massacres, is it still possible even to relax? Is it wise? The trail turns into the road down which drifters roam to lead our traveler to sidelines he must follow, to sift the detritus of social dysfunction, self-medications, and mental health. He will find cruelty and darkness, death and loneliness, and a father once lost but reclaimed through nature, and clues to mathematical formulae too large to calculate but that seem to point to the same elemental attractions, the ones that bind the physical world and personal memory. But humor and darkness work as well together as rock music and memories. He will look for fun too, pure fun, and he will find it. A writer and photographer wanders into nature, metamorphoses like Kafka, and explores on shaky, newfound legs the possibilities of human and natural history and real and pretended geographies, following facts to legends and myths, and on to rumors and wild speculations about the future, the past, and right now.